Okay, now that our vest and lining are pinned together, we are ready to sew. But before we do, I want to show you what I've done. Now, I had you to pin at the main points, but I also want you to go back and in between those main points, insert as many pins as you feel are necessary for your comfort to sew the pieces together. So here we have the fronts and the back. So along the neck edge, down the front, and along the bottom, I've pinned. Okay, on both sides. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to start at one bottom, and we're going to sew from that side edge of the bottom all the way around or across the bottom, the bottom of the front, actually, the bottom of the front, up the center front, across the neckline, back down the other neckline, the center front, and then across the bottom, ending at the side front. Then we're going to sew the arm side. So we've pinned that all together. We're going to sew from one end all the way around to the other on both sides. Now for the bottom, let's turn this around so you can see the bottom for the back. Now I have pinned straight across, okay? So it's pinned from one end to the other, but I want to show you this center back portion here where you have that V cutout. Now, to pin this section, I don't want you to press the seam allowances flat and insert a pin there. What you're going to need to do is open out your seam allowance. Open out your seam allowance. And then you're going to insert, let me just take a pin. You're going to open it out. It's opened out on both sides. And you're going to go ahead and insert your pin right there. And when you come around this bottom edge and pivot to go up to this V, you're going to sew right up to where that mark is. You should have marked a dot onto your fabric, both of your outer fabric and your lining fabric. So you're going to stop right there, back stitch, and remove the fabric. Then you're going to do the same thing on the other side. You're going to open out your seam allowances, place your pin right there, and you can either start here or you can start in this edge. Whichever way, you're going to start or end at this dot, back stitch, and end your stitching there. In the instructions, it tells you to sew across the bottom, breaking stitches at the point. That's what it means. To break the stitches is to sew to that point, to stop, and then start again at the other, on the other side of that point. Okay? So we are going, we're going to go ahead and sew it together, and we're going to start with this bottom back piece so you can see how we start and stop at the point. So let's go ahead and sew that together. Before we go any further, this is a good time to check your bobbin thread to make sure you have enough thread to attach the vest and the lining. All right, after you have done that, we're going to start at the bottom, and I'm going to sew from the side edge of the bottom of the back piece over to this point to show you how to do that. And we're using a 5/8 inch seam allowance, or 5/8 inch seam, yeah. Until you think you're at the 5/8 inch mark, and then with your needle still down in the fabric, lift your presser foot and turn it and measure to see if you are on the 5/8 inch line. If not, turn it back and go whichever direction you have to go. If you're not quite there, stitch one more stitch. If you went too far, then back stitch. Check it again. And I'm right at the 5/8 inch mark now. So I'm going to turn mine back and do a back stitch and come back forward to that point. And then I'm going to pivot. Okay, and remember, we need to make sure that the seam allowances are opened out, and we're going to sew to this point and back stitch. Okay, and that's breaking the stitching. Then we're going to go and do the same thing on the other side. This time I'm going to start right here at the point, just in case you guys end up doing that. So pin, insert your fabric right at that point at the 5/8 inch line on your needle plate, starting right at that point. So be careful that you're lining it up, and just use your hand wheel to turn it down to see if you're in the right place. Okay, and then when you find that spot, go ahead and lower your presser foot. Stitch forward a couple of stitches and then back stitch. And continue. Stop when you think you have reached the 5/8 inch mark again and pivot. Okay, good. Okay, we have stitched our bottom, the hem of the back together. We'll go and do all the trimming after we finish the rest of the seams. So what you will do from this point is go ahead, like I showed you earlier, and sew the arm side on both sides. Sew around the neck, down the front, the center front, the front neckline, all the way around, and then meet me back here and I'll show you what to do next. Okay, after you have attached the lining to your vest, go ahead and trim away the seam allowances and all the areas where you have sewn. And when you get to the bottom piece, I want to show you how to handle that where the V is, the bottom on the back. Okay, so I've done this side already. I just trimmed away the seam allowance, and before trimming away this side, I cut into the seam allowance up to that point where we formed the V. So I'll show you on this side. So I have this seam allowance still present. Whenever you're cutting away the seam allowance at your points, go ahead and cut diagonal to the points. And you can do that before trimming away the rest of the seam allowance. Go ahead and find all the points and just trim diagonally to that point. All right, and then go ahead and trim away the rest. And I'm just cutting away maybe half or a little more than half of that seam allowance. Okay, we have opened out the seam allowance on both sides, making sure that this side is out of the way because we don't want to snip into the point and ruin anything. So we've opened out the seam allowance, and we're going to take our scissors and we're going to clip up to that dot without cutting through the seam. Okay, making sure that's out of the way. Go ahead and cut right up to that dot just before the seam. All right, and what that's going to do is give us a nice crisp point at the center of the V. Okay, then you can go away or go ahead and trim this bottom portion here. All right, and then you see, you when you open the seam allowance back out, you have those little points. You can just snip those off. Just, you know, hold it together and snip it off on both sides, on the lining and on the outer fabric. Okay, so now we have a really nice clean edge there when we turn it right side out. All right, now to turn it right side out, let's clean up here. This fabric has been pretty messy that I'm using, but that's okay, it'll be nice when it's all done. Okay, so here is the vest from the front. Now, we're going to turn it right side out. So I'm gonna go in from the open side. Remember, we didn't sew the sides up. And I'm gonna just pull that through. I'm gonna reach and pull it all the way through. Okay, and I'm gonna keep reaching until I have every, oh, I just found a pin. Be careful before you pull those sides through. If you still have a pin in your belt where we were keeping the belt out of the way, go ahead and remove those pins so that you don't stick yourself. Let me find the other one. Yeah, you don't want to get stuck, and you don't want to sew those or have the belt stuck inside anyway. Here we are. Okay, so let's continue. We're gonna pull it through. Continue pulling the entire vest through that one side seam. Okay, we got that side out. Now let's flip it out. Okay. There we go. Now, let's go back over here, and we're gonna stick our hand in and continue to pull, and that's the back that just came out. Okay? There we have our points on the bottom, and we're gonna use our point turner in just a second. We're just gonna make sure we get everything out, and then here is the other side, or the other front. Okay? There we go. Now, let's grab our point turner, and starting on one of your front pieces, go ahead and push out all of your points so that you can get a nice crisp corner wherever there are points. Okay? So you want to go through the entire vest all the way around and push out the corners. All right? Once you have done that, give it a good press at the pressing station. So you're going to take your vest to the pressing station after you know everything is all straightened out and you have your nice corners, and press it flat, making sure that you're folding right on the seam where your lining and your vest meet, because you don't want your lining peeking out to the front. So make sure you're folding right along that seam line and giving it a nice press all the way around. Okay, after you do that, meet me back here and I'll show you how we're going to sew up the sides. We have our back and the front. Place those together with the right sides together of your outer fabric, and then go ahead and grab your outer fabric and match the notches and pin that into place. And continue pinning. Now let's go back up to the top. We're gonna pin this together, making sure that the seams are matching. Okay, just make sure your seams match. And then we're going to go 1 inch above that seam onto the lining, so you can use your seam gauge if you have to. So we're gonna pin right about here, and that's where we're gonna start our stitching. So I'm gonna go ahead and place this one in that direction so I can know that's where I'm gonna start. So we're gonna start 1 inch above the seam, and down here at the bottom, same thing, make sure you match that seam. That seam line, and then we're going to go 1 inch below that seam about right here. And then we're gonna end our stitching there, okay? So let's place this on the machine. And it's a little tricky, but you have to manipulate the fabric because it's within a hole. So go ahead and leave that inside and flip this open, or flip this up. Let's move our machine here. And I'm gonna place this onto the machine right at that point at the 5/8 inch mark. Okay, right where that pin is. Yes, that's about it. Okay, and then we're gonna make sure that you're only sewing two layers of fabric. You wanna make sure you don't get any of the other lining caught up in there. So move that lining out of the way. And we are ready, making sure those seams are matching. Let's go ahead and do a couple of stitches and then back stitch. And sew all the way down. Oops, remove that pin so it doesn't prevent the fabric from moving through. As you go, continue to move that lining out of the way. And you know, I'm going to suggest that you do a basting stitch on this first for your first round, and then try it on your model. Whoever you're making this for, well, if it's not a surprise, go ahead and try it on that person. See if it fits. If it's too big, then you can go in and sew a larger seam allowance. I'm gonna go ahead with the 5/8 inch and then we'll continue. If you're trying to surprise them, then you just go ahead and sew it up and hope that it fits. Coming up on the end here, so I want to make sure I don't have any fabric under there and that everything is straight. To stop there and backstitch. Okay, so what you're gonna do, first let me just show you. So the outer fabric seam is all closed up, all right? However, the lining has this opening. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna go to the sewing or the pressing station, and you're gonna go ahead and press this seam open all the way. Open it out, place it on your ironing board, and press that flat, open and flat all the way. Then you're gonna come back and you're going to fold in your lining. Okay, so press the seam you just sewed in, come back, and whip stitch the lining closed. Okay, I have pressed open the side seam, and we're ready to whip stitch the lining closed. So let me show you on the inside. The seam has been pressed flat. And what I did also while I was at the pressing station is I folded over the edges of my lining and gave it a light press so that it would stay folded and in place and make it easier when I insert the whip stitch. So you're going to thread a needle with a double layer of thread, not one end, and we're going to be whip stitching with a single layer of thread, of course. So you're just going to go in. I'm going to start at the top. You start wherever is more comfortable for you, and I'm just going to grab one side. Let me put my glasses on. You're going to grab one side and pull the thread through until it stops, and then you're going to grab the other side and then grab the side, the left side. So you're going to be grabbing the left and the right side. Ooh, I keep catching that thread. You're going to grab the left side and the right side right on the fold and just stitch that closed from the top to the bottom. And that's pretty simple. Okay, so just keep doing that. Grab the right fold and the left fold as close as possible to get a nice, neat closure. And then, if you can see that, maybe not because the fabric and the thread are both black. Now let's attach our buckle to the belt. So grab your buckle and the right belt, and you're going to insert the belt through the buckle around that center prong, and then you're going to fold it over, and you're going to leave about an inch, you know, fold over about an inch. And then what we're going to do is we're going to insert stitching to secure this in place. All right, so let's get our machine. Now you can stitch this by hand if you'd like. I'm going to go ahead and do it by machine so I can get it done quicker. I think I'll sew from this side. I'm going to top stitch right about there. So line it up to where you can get as close to the end as possible, or as close to the edge of the under flap as possible. There you have your buckle, and then to secure it after he puts the vest on, or before, you can just go ahead and slide it like that, and then you can adjust it to his size. Okay, the next thing we're going to do is we're going to make the buttonholes on the front of the vest. So grab your buttonhole guide, that one pattern piece that we cut out, and meet me back here at the machine. Okay, we have two steps left to complete the vest. We're going to do top stitching around the entire vest, and we're going to insert the buttonholes and attach the buttons. So first, you can see I've already completed. I inserted my buttonholes, I've attached my buttons, and I've done the top stitching. So for the top stitching, what you're going to do is you're going to start, I started in the back here in the V area. You can start wherever you like, but what you're going to do is you're going to top stitch using a quarter inch seam allowance all the way around. So you're going to start wherever you choose to start and just go all the way around, pivoting at your points, and just top stitch all the way around the entire vest. And then you're going to go and do the same thing at the arm side. And I started at the underarm seam. The underarm seam, and just top stitch all the way around using a quarter inch, and then that will be complete. After you do your top stitching, you're going to use your buttonhole guide to mark the front of your vest for your buttonholes. So number 10 pattern piece is your buttonhole guide, and the way you're going to lay it on top of your vest is where it says top. You're going to place that piece at the top here at the point. All right, so place it. Let's open this out. So you have your vest in front of you, and this is the left front, okay, for the men. Place the top of the pattern piece at the top, right along this finished edge here, and you will see that it, or it should line up perfectly, all right? Then you're gonna take your pins, and you're gonna pin this into place using a few pins. You don't need too many pins. So I would do 1, 2, 3, or however many you wanna use. Then what you're gonna do is you're gonna take your tracing wheel and your tracing paper, place your tracing paper on top here. So actually you're gonna move your pins over to the edge so that you can get your tracing paper under there. Let's do one more. Okay, so make sure that this is lined up evenly along the edge so that when you mark your buttonholes that they'll be in the right place. So take your tracing paper, and I didn't bring any over. So take your tracing paper under and place it under the tissue paper with the transfer side facing down onto your fabric, of course. Place it there, and then you're going to just trace these buttonhole lines. So just trace each one, and you have 4 buttonholes. All right, and when you remove your pins, you'll have the markings to go ahead and insert your buttonholes. Now, for the buttonholes, for those of you who are new to sewing and you've never done a buttonhole, I suggest you go and watch lesson number 6 in my beginner's sewing course, because we do a shirt dress, and we actually install buttonholes and apply buttons. So you can go and take a look at that tutorial to learn how to do buttonholes. Or you can just take a look at the owner's guide for your sewing machine to learn how to use your buttonhole foot if it comes with one, or how to do buttonholes manually. All right, so go ahead and insert your buttonholes, and then you can use your buttonholes as a guide to placing your button onto the right front. So after you have your buttonholes installed, you're gonna just go ahead and overlap. And I suggest putting this on your model, the person you're making the vest for, and after he has it on, then go ahead and overlap the left onto the right and pin it into place on him while it's on him. Go ahead and pin it in between the buttonholes, and then take one of your marking tools and right in the opening of your buttonhole, just go through there and push through the opening. I'm not going to do it because I don't want to mark this fabric, but push through in the corner of the buttonhole where it opens, and make that mark. Okay, so for each one, just go and push the pin through and make a mark. Push the marker through the opening of the buttonhole and make a mark so that you have your marks in the right place. And when you try it on him, make sure everything is lined up properly. You know, make sure your bottom is lined up so it's not uneven. Like, you don't want to have it on him and have it uneven like that and mark your buttonhole. So make sure everything is lined up properly when you're pinning it in place, and then make your buttonholes. And that will complete the vest. But there's one thing I want to draw your attention to. Take a look at my vest on the front. I'm not sure if you can see it, but there is a mistake. And I wanted to bring it to your attention just in case it happens to you. Now, remember when I showed you how to attach the welt to the front, and I told you that this angle needs to point toward the side of the vest? Well, I did that here, but on this side, I didn't pay attention, and my angle is pointing toward the front of the vest, and that is off. If you look at this from the front, it's off. So what I'm gonna need to do is I'm gonna have to go in on that side seam that we closed up with hand stitching on the lining. I'm gonna have to open that up. I'm gonna have to remove this and redo it. I mean, I could leave it if I wanted to, but I don't feel right. That doesn't look right. I can't have my husband walking around looking like that. That's lopsided. So I'm gonna go and fix that. So if you happen to make that mistake, it's okay. You can fix it. All right? So you guys go ahead, do your top stitching, go ahead and put your buttonholes in, attach your buttons, and then you will be done. Meet me back at the cutting table, and then I have a few words for you. Thank you. Okay, you guys, we are done with our vest, and here it is. It turned out really nice. There's the front, and here's the back. You guys will also get to see pictures of my husband wearing it, and I'll share pictures of him wearing the first vest that I made for him in the beautiful brocade fabric. So if you have enjoyed this tutorial, I invite you to hit the like button, to comment, and share with your friends. Also, I invite you to subscribe to my channel because I have a lot more coming. I have some really great tutorials lined up, and I want you to be a part of that. I invite you to go over to my blog, Anita by Design, and you can check out more pictures of my husband wearing this vest, and you can see some of the other things that I do that I'm not doing tutorials for. As always, remember, when you live in your design, it is from there that God shines. Bye-bye.